Award-winning journalist Robert Fisk was in Dubai this morning to unveil his latest book, The Age of the Warrior, which is a collection of his writings from Britain's Saturday Independent newspaper. Fisk spoke exclusively to Emirates News' Ibrahim Ashahrani about the new book and his visit to the UAE.
We're here this morning with Mr. Robert Fisk, Britain's most decorated foreign correspondent, a man that's covered the Middle East for more than 30 years, a man that needs no introduction. He's here in Dubai to launch his latest book, The Age of the Warrior. And before we get to the book, I'd like to ask you, why did you choose to base your career on the Middle East, of all places?
Well, I was in Portugal covering the aftermath of the Portuguese Revolution, and I was working for the London Times. We had a correspondent in Beirut who was just getting married, and his wife didn't want to live in a civil war. This is 1976. And my foreign editor, who's long dead, wrote me a letter, which I still have, saying, I'm offering you the Middle East. And he said, it'll be a great adventure and lots of sunshine, which is certainly true, the second part of it. And I came to Beirut, and after 3 years, they wanted me to do another 3 years, and they didn't want me to leave. And of course, the longer you stay in a place, the better you know it, the better you know the people, the less well you know your editor, but that's the way it goes. And I never left. I stayed on.
After our interview, Mr. Fisk read selected passages from his latest book. He commenced with one of my favorites, an article describing his beginnings as a journalist in Northern England. Notice his ability to use words to paint a vivid image in the mind's eye.
I was 17 when I first arrived in Newcastle-upon-Tyne. It was a city of heavy, black 19th century buildings, a spider's web of iron bridges and smouldering steam locomotives, the air thick with coal smoke and red haze from the steelworks at Consett. The news editor of the Evening Chronicle, that was my paper, John Brownlee, did his best to cheer me up. You'll be in our Blythe office, Bob, a bustling little coal town on the coast with plenty of life and lots of news. Brownlee was in estate agent mode.
It's a book that deals very much with Iraq and what's gone wrong in Iraq. But it's also about many other subjects he's covered over the years. Cinema, the use of language, and what he calls the bad journalism of the West. It's about death and what it means. It's about the Second World War as well. It's a whole series of articles that you can go through from stage to stage. But laced throughout it all is the tragedy that is Iraq. As Middle East correspondent, Fisk covered the 1979 Iranian Revolution, the 8-year Iran-Iraq War, and the 1991 Gulf War. He was one of two Western journalists to stay in Beirut throughout the Lebanese Civil War.
I launched my last book, The Great War for Civilization, in Dubai. It had a great reception, sold a lot of copies. And you have a very good reading public here, not just expatriates, but Emirate people too. It's a very reading public in Dubai, much more so than, say, Bahrain. Probably about the same as Cairo. And I will be going to Cairo later on to launch it there as well. Beirut is a pretty good market, but of course they're waiting for the French edition there and the Arabic edition, which we haven't yet published.
And after entertaining questions from the audience, Mr. Fisk personally signed copies of his book. And like everyone else that came today, I'll keep the book and the experience with me for years to come. Ibrahim Ashahrani for Emirates News.